pulls the turn to the right. Quarter turn to the right. This is why we practice. Quarter turn to the right. No point is anyone relaxing. Okay. Open the wiser. Every pose with a sense of urgency. Into your lat spread. Spread the lat spread. Squeeze back. Go forward. From the side to your side chest. If that comes to you on the day, if that ever happens, just do it. Change. Don't wait for permission. You do what you love it. And face the rear. It's a lot tighter in the hamstrings and the glutes curl. Back double bicep, show the calf. I still can't see that left hamstring tight. Last breath. Needs to be spiking the calf as well here. Calf. Needs to be spiking the calf. Yeah. Side tricep. Locking it down. And round. Just a moment, boys, on here. Good. And raise the front. Making a quad, abs and thighs. And your most muscular. Power the quads. Feet slightly closer to the other. Even closer. Yeah. Okay, so that was all round posing. That's going to happen when you first come on stage. And then if
spot on.
Yeah.
expected this. It's like, you've always been a bit like, should I turn to my gate?
Okay, so you're going to be about this far apart on stage. Okay, so
I was going to say, just real quick.
Yeah.
I've seen people crash their fucking arms. It gets well angry.
Yeah. It's like you'll get pulled out on stage. Yeah. Like me, especially, he'll be, he'll say number 27, or we might call your name. Yeah. So it's got being a trick.
Right, okay, yeah.
And that's good. Cool. And then that will put you off. The judges may even be like, I wanted that first. Anyway. Okay, so front relaxed. Let's go through these and remember, they're never relaxed. Okay, it's called relaxed, it's not relaxed. You want to be creating as much lead taper as possible. So we're wanting to see your lats. We're wanting to see your lats like this. We're wanting to keep our elbows high enough and roll our shoulders forward enough to see our lats. Think of our lats spread, okay? And that's how you want to be holding this. Then lower our hands down just a tad, both of you. Okay, and you both need to bring your feet slightly closer together. Yep. And flare your quads. Here, this is tight on the quads now. This is spiking your legs. Okay, squeezing your quads. Now, go with that again. And then open up by bending your knees slightly. There, that's flaring your quads. See how much more separation there is when you do that? Okay, now you're seeing everything right from the top, and obviously as you're going to get leaner through the weeks, that's going to be more obvious. You can see a lot more separation if that happens. You're hitting this perfectly, James. Okay, so from here, in terms of what you're doing with your abs...
Yeah, I feel like I'm squeezing, I don't feel I should.
Don't crunch down, just suck it in, almost like a vacuum. Try and get all the air into your chest, nice and high. Okay, and create as much of a shelf as you can. But, okay, remember, hard on the legs the whole time. It's hard work if you do it properly. A little more flare in the quads, front of the lats. Perfect. You're going to hold, as soon as you're both hitting right, you're going to hold for a few seconds as you have, and quarter turn to your right. From here, you don't relax.
Oh shit, oh,
there's no relaxing. Right, okay. If you're on stage, you're being judged.
Right.
Okay, even if it's like, if you go, my guys relax, there's no relaxing.
Oh, right, you can't blow out then.
So you've got more transition from a front relaxed, okay, yeah, that's it. Okay, front relaxed, transition is in straight away. Okay,
right, okay.
Yeah, that's what we're going to be doing. So it's not going to be relaxed. So back into your front relaxed, just for a second. Flare, quads, that's it, out. Okay, right, quarter turn to your right. Yeah. And yes, remember the judges are over here where I am. Okay, so I need to be seeing width, and I need to be seeing a narrow waist, wide shoulders. So blow out the air, twist into this, blow out the air, and squeeze. You can crunch out a tap, there we go. Okay, now you're always looking this way. Okay, so hit this, James.
That way.
You're going to be looking forward. So, that's good. Now, keep this heel down, James. On your side poses, keep your heels down. Not on your side chest, but on your side relaxed poses. So, right, looking forward.
Same way,
James.
Straight
ahead. Perfect. That's hit. And then quarter turn to your right. Without quarter turn to your right, so you're facing the rear.
Yes.
Excellent.
Ah, right, okay.
Great. From here, this is the first time the judge is going to see you from the rear. So they're looking at hamstring and glute development, how lean they are. So you've got to be tight in the hamstrings. Like you're almost in a hamstring curl. That's tensing your quads. I want to tense your hamstrings. That's good. So, yeah, so basically, you're doing a hamstring curl with a slight bent knee. There. Much better. You're hitting this perfect. Start. We both need to roll the shoulders forward slightly. You need to open up the scapula quite a bit up. Good. Now, chest really high. There. Okay, hold. That's your relaxed. Yeah, fantastic. And quarter turn to your right.
Look at this one.
Yep, that's it. And we're out of the script. That's it.
So, I want you to, both of you, blow out your air, and remember, both heels in four gems.
That's alright.
So it's a little hammered.
Yeah, yeah. No, and it should be a habit for your side chest and side tricep if you're relaxed and you're down. Fantastic. You need to twist it a little bit more. No, that's it. So keep the mirror's obviously here for guidance today. You won't be obviously on, okay? But if you can't see your left chest in this pose here, you're not twisting your left. Right, this is how much James is twisting here. That's what you're doing. You're both hitting your arms really well. You're not covering your abdomen, so make sure that you're seeing your abdomen in the mirror. Okay? And actually, both of you just relax, stay where you are. Okay, so when we're hitting our side relax, we want our feet together, but actually, back to the back of the station over here. Okay, we want to be back over here, so. Turn the feet, both of them that way, okay? And then twist all the way around into this. Okay, then we're looking ahead. Okay, we're going to squeeze the chest here. Keep the elbow nice and high. And this way, we're going to be showing hamstring in the side slot.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Looking straight ahead now.
Okay.
And basically just comes through now.
Yeah, yeah. Everyone keeps going on about these. Oh, thanks. Yes. It's kind of
fucking match, mate. Right. Okay, right, so let's go through these again. And I'm going to just both of you shout out instructions on it that's kind of just in the moment. Okay, so front relax. Okay, both of you just relax a second, actually relax. When we're hitting every pose, what I should have mentioned, a bit of urgency. Okay, so as soon as they say, yeah, bang, you hit it there. Okay, so the judges look at you and they're not going, you're not like
getting ready.
Right. Yeah. And then they're wandering around looking at everyone else and they're like, oh, he's pretty good.
You know, it's that show, as soon as the first one hits it, you're like, oh.
So you want to raise their confidence.
Yeah.
Even if you're feeling shit nervous, which you will be. Get out on stage, front double bicep, and be like, bang, bang, bang. Okay, and they'll be like, oh fuck, you know, straight away.
All right.
Okay, so let's go, front relaxed. Much better. Okay, remember, flare and relax. So like you're doing a lat spread, okay? And then just put your arms up. Excellent, both of you flaring your quads. See how James is flaring his quads here? Knees are coming out wide. Excellent, you're seeing a lot more separation from top to bottom, and this is what you're looking at here. Get the chest a little bit higher, car. And quarter turn to the right. Both feet together, and yes, yeah, and on the floor, and pointing towards slightly the back of the stage, James. So that's it. Twist more into it. Twist and in a little bit. Up the air, blow out the air, and crunch down on here. Crunch down on here. Go ahead, and quarter turn to the right. Hard on the hamstrings, first, and that's it. Carl, you need to make sure you're hard on the hamstrings from the time you're facing the rear, because that is a strength of yours. If you're not showing it, you can't see it. Okay. James, again, real hard on the hamstrings. It has to have the heels quite close together, not quite as close as that half. So, hard on the hamstrings, both of you, and you need to definitely open up this scapula here. Open this up. That's it. Good. Quarter turn to the right. Hit it hard and fast. Okay. Have a little look in the mirror. Can you see your left chest? If not, rotate more. Excellent. Blow out in the air. Show your obliques on the right side. And face the front. And that is how they'll start your round. And then we go into our mandatory poses, which we'll do now.
Hey, that's how we're
going to do this now. You may be posing for 10, 15 minutes on stage. If you're getting the call out, so there's 10 of you, and they go, right, that's 5 to the back. You might be going to stand up as well, going through your mandatories. You know, at the Worlds, I was like 35 minutes sponsoring on stage. And just pissing with sweat, everyone's gasping for air, like, guys, do you want a minute? You wouldn't be that guy who's like, no, I'm fine.
Yeah.
You know, okay, so this is where the practice is. So front, relaxed, because that's what you're going to do on stage. You never stand on stage. Actually relax. You do that backstage. On stage, this is your relax, at minimum. And if they say, James, to run to the back of the stage, don't assume that the judges can't see you. They can. You may not be in the spotlight.
Yeah.
But if you're at the back of the stage, this is how you sit and stand. Yeah.
I was going to say with my hands, is that all right where it should?
Not too high, it depends on the structure. For me, I kind of like just above the waist.
Yeah.
And it depends, you don't want to see some people like this. It looks ridiculous and it actually makes you look narrower. So I want to basically think of posing right now as 90%. So hit it 90% of the time. You're not doing the most muscular 100%, you're hitting 90%. So you can stand there like that for 5 minutes. Okay? It'll be hard, but 5 minutes. Okay, from here, front of the bicep, let's see where we're at. Good hold. And relax, actually relax. Okay, so the only things with that is both hit that really well, as in terms of coming out and then hitting that hard, that's fine. Carly needs to be on your legs. You were just completely focusing on the body, which is great, but on stage, from a spectator's point of view, from a judge's point of view, your body's half of your body.
Yeah.
Your legs are half of your body, so you can't neglect that. Hit the legs first for that reason, even if it's a bicep shot, so hit your legs first. The same way as you would your front relaxed with a front of the bicep. Let's both hit that. James will go with yours again, but keep your heels a little narrower, Don't forget you've got these big sweep quads, okay? So show them off. You want to be seeing a sweep from top to bottom, this wide, and that's just going to be excelled, on this stage. Excellent. Both hitting this. Sorry. Much better than both of you. And relax. Excellent. Yeah, perfect. Okay, we're going to keep going. So, here, we're not going to relax totally. So, I want to see how you cope with this. So, go into when I say relax, you go from a front wall bicep,
straight
and then I say and relax, and you go into your front relax.
Okay.
And then I go into a lat spread. Then I say relax. So, it'll be quarter turn to your right, or quarter turn to any side, for a side chest, etc. Okay, so, front wall bicep, legs, every time. Elbows forward slightly, pal. Hitting that perfectly. And relax. And relax, right. And you're hitting your legs exactly the same as again. Remember, we're wanting to see lat width under those armpits. This isn't the most muscular. This is the way I would hit this is relax, both of you. The way I'd hit this is from here. Do a bit of a row, feel your lats engage.
Okay.
Put your thumbs in the lower part of your lats and then come forward to the sides, if that makes sense. So you start with the thumbs behind you and then open up your lats as you bring your elbows forward. Okay? So you shouldn't end here. You should start here and then end actually trying to open up your lats, create more of a detail as you use your fists.
Oh shit, that's better that is. That's fucking
nice. So, and don't forget, it's going to be able to make. So, have a look in the mirror now. Sorry, I'll come back.
Sorry, just one second.
Okay, have a look in the mirror now. Yeah. Okay, so not much going on with the lats here. Okay, and you've not changed the waist. Now, put your hands back again. This time, here. All the way forward here. That's it. Now, push the knee to the waist. Roll your shoulders forward, but keep your chest really high. Right, you're making your waist look narrower now. Okay, but we need to, from here, try and get the chest really high. There. Okay, so you're taking 2 inches off your waist, and okay, add 2 inches to your lats. Okay, you're trying to get your arms forward. Okay. Get the chest really high. I know it's hard because you're kind of, you're trying to do this and this at the same time.
That's so much better than that. And your arms as well.
Don't forget those quads. Right, and that is how you're going to be hitting your front lats row. Okay? Just relax a second. James, go for the lats row.
That's hard work, that one.
Hard work. Yeah, excellent. So you can clearly see over arm hips, you've got your lats flared. Okay, you can't get your lats any more flared than that. Your quads stay really high on the quads. If there's a little bit, very easy to bend. It's very easy to switch off your quads if you did a little bit. Okay, and from here, you want to keep your chest really high. Don't forget, you're going to be totally pumped on the day, so it's going to be very easy to connect with the muscles. Excellent. Brilliant.
Both form the elbows back while you're doing the row, so you squeeze your lats, thumbs in the lower part of your lats, and then roll the shoulders forward, chest really high, flare the quads. There. Quads. Excellent. Chest high. We'll see lats under the armpits. And lats, excellent. Excellent. Okay, and then you're going to pick your favourite side of the side chest. Just pick that side, yeah, I will go on that side. Most people who are right handed would be this side. Okay, so when you pick your side chest, what you're doing upper half is great, what you're doing lower half is relaxing. You need to be spiking the calf. Okay, so spiking the calf, so put your tips up. You need to be legs together, so you can show some meat in your hamstrings, and you get this as well for legs. James hits it perfectly, first time. So notice how toes again need to be further back, so you can see more sweep in the legs, like James here.
I'm not pushing that.
Excellent. So right now, I want you pushing this leg into here. So we can kind of make that the belly of that that hamstring pop a little bit more. Okay. So actually push your legs together. Put your legs together as hard as they can, and then spike it back. Okay.
Bend that leg.
Spike that calf. I can't see anything going on with the calf mode. There it is. Okay, now we're focused on our body. And you need to be twisting a little more here. Hands down here. Okay.
So you can twist the spine as well. Okay. So you're both
getting the arms perfectly here. And relax. We're going to hit that again. So, go to your relax. Into a side chest. So the way I would transition here is literally 1, 2, 3. Yeah? 2. Okay. I like to crunch down a little bit into this, blow up my air and show some oblique. Yeah. So still behind this. So keep this on the show. Both hitting that so much better. And we'll push those legs together. That's it. And face the rear. So then we ask to face the rear and then relax. So now you're being judged on muscularity and condition. So where's condition on the rear? It's going to be glutes and hamstrings. How lean are they? Okay, so make sure that you are tensing. Okay, feet can remain quite close together. But the way we are going to hit this, same way you are now, the way we're going to hit this is the first one's going to be a back of a bicep. Okay, so your back, one of your legs, which I suggest both of you, your left leg, is going to be back and out slightly.
Yeah.
Spiking the calf, tensing the hamstring, so your tension here, and tensing the glute as well. And then you're going to go up. Let's do this as a practice for now. Yeah. So notice how this heel is pointing inwards a little bit. Up, down. And then flare the lats, open, and elbows forward. Hold. Not bad at all. Don't lean too far back, James. If you lean too far back, it creates a shadow. Okay, you're going to lose some definition. The elbows a little bit higher up. Good. And spike on this hamstring. By turning this knee out, then let it knee out. Tuck the hamstring out. That's it. Much better. See how much easier it is to keep that tight.
Yeah,
so that's the perfect amount of lean back right there.
Got to try that.
Got to try that.
Is it better on either side?
I think. Does it feel easier to hit that?
I feel like I can squeeze it hard. I can do it.
No, if you feel you can squeeze that hard, that's the more you go with.
what's happening on your back is exactly the same. Okay. What's happening on your legs is exactly the same. If you feel more balanced on one side, for me, because I've got this hip injury, I hit this here, and my knee comes in.
Okay.
So I can't stay on my foot with my hamstring, so I go with the left hand side instead.
Okay.
Try the whole right as well. We need to turn that your right knee outwards. Turn your hamstring, right knee out. There. And then you can be tight here. Still tighter. On the hamstring. That's it. And then you can open this scapula. You can open this scapula. You're twice as wide. Excellent. And relax. Excellent. Okay. Right, we are going to hit that again in a second, and with a bit of confidence, so you're going to say face the rear, okay, from the side chest, and they'll say relax, this is how relax, and then they'll say face the rear, relax, and then you back double bicep, and it'll be like bang, bang, bang.
Okay. So you get the way
to do that.
Fucking bang,
it's
a fucking
yes, man. Yeah, judges want to be drawn to you and not the competition. So, here's your relax. Let's try from the side chest.
Side chest.
Just for the half our side chest for now. Just for the transition.
With the side chest, do you have to sit and do the same side?
No.
I think that's a good
idea. It's your favourite side.
Yeah, alright, it's now.
Yeah. So, side chest, half our side chest. Okay? And relax.
Yeah.
Yep. Remember, feet on the floor when you relax, that's it. Okay, face the rear. So we relax. Back of the bicep. Good. You have. So adjust it. Don't wait until the next pose. Adjust it straight away. Good. Excellent. And lat spread. So I would keep my feet where they were. Stay exactly the same.
Okay.
And lat spread. Hamstrings curl. Good. Yeah. You're doing a great job, Jez, of hitting the legs first. Keep those lats flared. And relax. No, actually relax. Okay. Good. Okay. And we've gone straight back from our side chest again. Back to the bicep. Nope, you know, legs first. Okay, relax again. Okay, both of you hit this right this time. Okay, with your rear relaxed, by the way, you'll tighten the hamstrings and the glutes. Good. Yeah. Carl, you've got glute striations coming through. When you tense the glutes, you squeeze the glutes and the hamstrings, and you shouldn't, you can't relax there in the rear, so you're going to have to focus on everything in the entire. It's exhausting, yes, but it's worth it. Okay, right. Back of the bicep. Excellent. Both of you hitting that really well. You need to open your scapula. That's it. Hamstrings can stay tight, curl, and that glute. Excellent. And that spread. Try to push that back and open it up.
Oh, my head. Keep the legs out.
Yep. Don't spend all day. The judges are doing it right now. Open the scapula. You're doing like a. There you go. Tighten on the lower body curl. Like you're doing a leg curl. You're actually focusing on trying to bring your foot back together. So. And relax. Okay, face the front. Good transition. That's exactly what I do. It'll be like. Literally straight down the bow, and it's going to be abs and thigh. This is the time then now, staying in the last pose. This is the time now where you are going to spike your quad. All up to now you've been kind of planning your quad. So a spike quad would be from here, I would go forward and to the middle of your, the centre of your body. That's where you want your foot to be. Turn your foot out slightly, and then hard on the quad, okay, because you want to show feathering here. Okay, so that's too far out, keep doing that,
further in. Keep it, lock the leg.
Lock the leg.
Yeah, locking the leg, spike.
So that toe, that. There you go. So you're showing the sweep, but you're showing the hardness all the way through. Lock the leg. So we're showing the hardness.
Good.
And then blow up the air and good. Blow up the air, so you couldn't do a crunch. So you want to be showing, we know that both of you should do a crunch. Do a crunch all the way down. Good. Don't suck in the air, blow out the air. Good. And into your relaxed. And you're most muscular. So now you're going to be, depending on the type of most muscular, both of you might go for the hands fast. Good. Which means that both of you flare on the quads. Okay. Brilliant. Hold, 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 and relax.
Excellent.
Okay. Both of you need to bring your hands even closer. Carl, because you've got the loose skin, what I would do is actually cover that with your fists. Okay? So, cover that with your fists. Don't lean too far forward because the lighting is going to be directly in front of you. If you come further than this, sorry, if you lean forward further than this, okay, there's going to be a shadow over you there. So you need to be up.
Not up. I'm just having a look, but.
Oh, right, is that fair enough? So you don't want it to be, the light's not going to be like it is here in front of you, it's going to be spotlighting over the top. So I want you to be blowing out your air and not leaning back, but up straight. If you lean forward, it's just going to be a shadow over you, okay? So, in terms of your abs, I can stack yourself a bit lower abdomen here with the knife, all the way in. Blow out all the air, crunch down, and squeeze the chest as hard as you can together, as much through the arms and the chest as you can. Okay, but don't forget the legs.
Yeah.
Wear those quads. That's it. So knees need to be flaring out a little bit. That's good.
It's fucking mad, the fucking lines in your chest.
Yeah.
It's brilliant.
That's brilliant. And that's what people are going to be drawn to here. James, let's hit yours.
Okay.
So harden the quads first, and then open them up. Good. So I would bring your hands, because you've got a slightly longer torso, you can bring your hands a bit higher.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's going to bring your elbows up slightly wider as well. Excellent. Yeah. Excellent. And all the fat sleeve, you've got more dense look here. You've got more definition for your chest. Okay, and palms, your palms together. So right now you're putting your knuckles together, put your palms together. Like you're going to slide, and you're bringing your palms together. Let's go. Yeah, like that a lot. Excellent. I think I'll change the heart at all. And that's really good. So you do want to show your abdomen.
Yeah.
Maybe just hiding your lower abdomen, just so you can bring your... You don't want your hands down here.
Yeah.
You bring them up a little bit so you've got a bit more arm delt going on. Okay, and then you squeeze them together. So, into your relaxed pose. Yeah, abs and thigh, bang.
Okay. More aggressive.
Yeah, aggressive. It's okay, as long as it's not arrogant, as long as it's not dead. But abs and thigh, but it's actually thigh and abs, yeah? Okay, so here, okay, you're going to be going bang, blow all the air, and get as much pop in the abs as you can. All the air out, try not to focus on. Bring your arms out of the way. What are you showing the biceps here? Just push that. Yeah. And your most muscular. Air out again. Just like that to play over. Okay? You can create a smaller waist, do it. Both of you need to be hiding your legs. Good. And good. And side tricep. So, yeah. Excellent. What you're doing with your legs is exactly the same as your side chest. So you need to be spiking the calf, hard on your hamstring, twisting around like your eye, side chest as well. This needs to be almost locked. That's it. You literally work straight in the tricep now. Now, lock your arm almost. You're doing this. I want you to move them out to here. Yeah. Okay, you're showing too much colour abdomen.
That's it.
Perfect. In fact, when you took the air in there, that looks pretty impressive. So, vacuum the air in, again. Okay, while you hit that side chest. Excellent. So, blow the air out, suck the air in. Get the air into your chest, lock this.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. And James.
Thickness of your triceps, man. Fucking ridiculous.
Yeah. Great shot. Great, literally, probably your strongest shot. Make sure that even though you're twisting round and this is priority, because you now the abs enough, because your knee links and you are showing this tricep, you want to be able to see the long end of the tricep as well. Okay. So tighten the hamstrings as well.
Okay, let's both of you relax.